The leading cause of death in women is coronary artery disease, by far. But having said that, women develop coronary artery disease almost 10 years later than men. Now, for many, many years, research focused on sex hormones like estrogen and progesterone as contributors to why women might be protected and then why after menopause they might have more risk. And there is a lot to be said and a lot of evidence that estrogen is indeed protective against coronary artery disease and also promotes a more favorable lipid profile, so good lipids rather than bad lipids.
Circulating lipids are fat molecules that are transported by the blood, but if they are too high, they will start to accumulate in and on the wall of the artery. And that accumulations will lead to building up plaques. These plaques hardens and narrows the artery, and this will lead to reduce the amount of blood flow to the vital organs. And this is what's called atherosclerosis.
And it sets into play a lot of inflammation and other processes that can then give you ultimately a heart attack. There are two major ways you make these lipids. You absorb them from your diet or you make them in your liver. So we looked at both of those, is how our XX chromosomes were influencing the levels of lipids in the blood and in the arteries. And what we found is that actually an XXX chromosome complement pretty much sets you totally into place to efficiently use fat. What our hypothesis would suggest is that we have evolved to be very efficient at absorbing and storing fat as women. We need it for childbearing purposes. We're mothers, we feed babies, we're set up potentially through our XX sex chromosomes to make us effectively absorb that lipid from the diet and put it into our fat cells and maybe even make it in the liver. Now, we're okay because estrogen is protecting us from getting it into the arteries and getting trapped there. But once we go through menopause and those levels of those sex hormones decline, then all we have, this is our hypothesis, is that XX, thrifty, fat-absorbing kind of genotype.
We found that the presence of 2X chromosomes increase the circulating lipids and atherosclerosis in mice. We believe that results from our studies provide important information to clinical care because this suggests that the female gonadal hormones like estrogens are unlikely to be the only determinants of the sex differences to the risk of coronary artery disease. So that means that there is another determinant of the sex differences, specifically genes on the sex chromosomes, and that could lead to the development of sex-specific therapeutic that could work in one sex but not in the other. The next step in this research, we are going to study the role of number of X chromosomes in atherosclerosis, because the results from these studies, we don't know if it's due to the presence of 2X chromosome or due to the absence of the Y chromosome.
We're looking at genes that are changed in the liver and in the intestine. And we're trying to find those targets. What kind of a target relates to serum lipids and atherosclerosis that might be a novel target that we haven't thought about before, that we could then go after with either an available drug or creating a new drug for that purpose. We may also use this information to guide women on the choice of their diet. For example, if they're very effective fat absorbers, obviously once they get postmenopausal, they need to be careful about the fat content. It might drive certain types of diets depending on your age and your menopausal status. I guess one of the exciting things for me is there are others that are studying this sort of area, but there are not that many in the cardiovascular system. So I'm excited because I think we have, with our tools and our knowledge, maybe a very defined path to get it, how we can use this information to drive therapy and prevent disease.